Hello everybody, I'm Eugene Kaspersky, the man with 30 years in cybersecurity. So I know the past, I see the present time, and I guess that in the future we'll have a revolution. Revolution in cybersecurity. So first of all, I'm going to speak about a little bit about the numbers, and the numbers are really scary. Today, we collect all the time, every day, about 340,000 samples. I mean, that we collect new files, applications, scripts, which we don't have in our archives, we don't have it in our collection. That's a new malware which we never saw before. More than 300,000 samples a day. It means that 3 days for us, it's a 1 million new malicious code. The cybercrime, unfortunately, still very active. The cybercrime, unfortunately, is profitable. And there are too many hackers in this business. And unfortunately, they are moving to the Internet of Things. With the Internet of Things, the numbers are also very scary. Now in our collection, the number of Internet of Things malware is counted by hundreds of thousands. Cybercrime, the hackers, they pay much more attention to the vulnerabilities in Internet of Things. The number of known vulnerabilities is growing year by year very quickly. The example of this kind of attack is Mirai botnet. Which is known for a couple of years already, and it's the most dangerous malware attack known till now. So there are hundreds of thousands of different samples which infected millions of the devices, mostly CCTV, mostly security cameras. There are many infected systems, they are still alive because the owners of the system, they don't care, and there is no Internet security, there is no antivirus for security cameras, and there are no update service for the cameras. So, if the camera is infected, I think the virus will stay there forever. So, it's the most active, the most dangerous, and the long life malicious project. The Internet of Things, they're everywhere around us. It's in our office, at our home, and in our city. So if you look around, you will see many of them. Security cameras, fire alarm systems, that's a smart TV. I don't know if this camera is connected to the network, or maybe yes, maybe not. So there are more and more Internet of Things around us. It's just everywhere. Then when you go home, you have the smart fridge, smart vacuum cleaner, smart coffee machine, smart door, and our houses, they get more and more smart. In the city, Internet of Things is also everywhere around us. It's a transportation, it's urban facilities, power grids, power plants, that's everything is highly computerized. And unfortunately, all the systems, they are vulnerable. In the past, we have to install and protect just one computer, which we had at home or in the office. Then we had more computers, and we have smartphones, which we also need to protect. And now there are hundreds of the Internet of Things around us. It means that we have to pay, we have to protect too many devices. And this is paradise for antivirus industry. Yes, I am from antivirus industry, but let's look at that from the other side. That's wrong. We need to invest too much into cybersecurity. So let's change it. I want to kill antivirus, to kill my business, and to replace it with a new revolutionary systems, which I call immunity. In my definition, cyber immunity means that the cost of attack is more than cost of possible damage. It means that hackers, they have to invest more than the possible victim lose. And for hackers, then, there is no reason to attack immune systems. How does it work? What's the difference? The traditional operating systems, which were designed in the 60s or 70s, well, not the code itself, but the architecture, the main ideas, they didn't have enough of security embedded into the system, simply because there are no requirements. So the standard operating system is operating system layer, then applications and security, the antivirus on the top of that. Unfortunately, the system is vulnerable. There could be some sandboxes, there could be some strict security there, but it still is possible to infect it. And our idea is based on a very different architecture. So the every model is, well, actually this architecture is microkernel. So all the components of operating system and applications, they are cut in the little pieces, in the little tiny models. Every piece of the system is under the strict control. It means that every piece of the system must have a permission to do what they want to do. In short, if you're a calculator, you have access to the keyboard, to the screen, but not to the internet. If you're a turbine, you have access only to the turbine, not to the internet, not to the screen, not to the keyboard. And our security layer embedded into the system controls all the behavior of all this application. It's not just control the behavior, it's a permission based. If you want to do anything in this system, please show your permission, show your ticket. In a standard operating system, if any piece of the system is compromised, it can affect the rest of the system. In our operating system, in our immune operating system, if there's something wrong with any model, it doesn't affect the rest of the system. In simple words, the standard operating system is a kind of house of cards. And immune operating system, it's a fortress. But in this fortress, it's a strict control on everyone who is in. I call it unhackable systems. And to inject the malicious code into it, it's a mission impossible. And it's not a dream, it's not the future. We have the devices, we have the system which are already made with our partners. For example, we have our operating system in a thin client. We have secure gateway for Internet of Things, and actually it's designed for the smart city concept. We made it with Advantech company. It works very well for the smart city when we need to connect thousands of the devices, thousands of the sensors to the same network. We also have with our partner Apratech and Siemens, we have a IoT secure gateway for industrial environment, so we can connect the SCADA systems to the internet and to guarantee that they are safe and secure. So I believe that the new cyber world, the future cyber world, will be based on cyber immunity. My mission and the mission of my company is to change the world and to help the world to accept and to develop the future based on the immunity. Based on the cyber immunity. Thank you very much. Eugene Kaspersky, we're here.